Hey everybody, it's Mark Ruggiero here, Clark Commando 1983, and it's June 18th, about 2 in the morning. I got my chemo coming up in a couple hours, 9:45, so this morning. So, sadly, been sleeping a lot, blah, blah, blah. Still trying to figure out what I want to do next for my next Learn to Play After Action report. And I am seriously considering doing some scenarios maybe or something from Compass Games of the War. Europe, 1939-1945. And recently picked up copy of the expansion, which I sold off sadly, and but was able to get it back in my collection. And it's this. Don't know if I'll actually use it. This is pretty hard to come by, the expansion, so I was happy to get it for a fairly decent price. The war is out of print, but you can actually get it pretty reasonably. I really don't know why. It's honestly, it's a really good game, and I'm gonna go over it. I have a punched and clipped copy. This is the unpunched copy because I have issues, and I, even though I've been selling most of my collection, I still have a couple games left. This is one of them where I have duplicates. It's one of my favorite subjects, right? Strategic World War II. Designed by, let's see here, Ernest Copley, developed by Paul Shackleton, and graphics design is Mark Mahaffey, and hopefully I got that right. It's also a Pacific version of this that I have. It's a two mapper. It's got a lot of good scenarios in it. I'm going to go kind of, I guess you could call it a box opening. I'm not going to call it that. I don't know what I'm going to call this video, to be honest with you. But maybe it's video one. I won't label it as such because I still haven't decided if that's what I'm going to do. But actually, hopefully going to be playing this live on Vassal soon. Got a date lined up. It's just a matter of my cancer cooperates. So hopefully, Scott, if you see this, things will work out. I have the printed newest edition rules, which are a few years old, but they're in my bedroom and my wife's sleeping right now, so not gonna go dig that out. Use 10-sided dice. One of the things I like about this game, and I have played it, it's been a few years. I played it when it first came out, which was in 2011, I think. There was a reprint, I'll look, which had no changes. Comes with a deck of different cards that I've never used. But when I say I have played it, I've played scenarios, I've played the campaign, only got up to, I think we got up to like 42 sometime. And what I like is Ed, the designer for this, is an experienced player, sadly doesn't play online, of World War II strategic games. He's played everything from World in Flames to Third Reich to just a bunch of different ones. Kind of took what he liked from each of the games and incorporated it in some way in this. And this is a, like I said, it's a core level game. It's got navies and the ships and the planes. So this has a rule book dated And I don't know if this is the latest. I got to look. Like you said, I've printed out a copy too. But copyright 2012. This may be a reprint. I'm such a fan of Compass Games that I probably ordered it. But I know for they were like, oh, it's going out of print. We're not going to reprint it. And then they reprinted it. Now, the rule book looks really hefty, and it is. Let's see here. Playtesters, Ken Dingley. Hey, Ken, I don't know if you're still around, but I remember you fondly. Used to be one of the owners. David Glenn, I know David. Alan Dixon. Is that you, Alan? I'll have to ask him if he actually, that's Alan Dickerson, who I'm thinking of. Might be a different Alan. of course, this is the cover art here. Reichstag, Fall of Berlin, April 45. The rule book, you know, honestly, is not... what's the word I'm looking for? Not slim. It's 118 pages altogether with the blanks. It's got tables in here. I just noticed on the bottom in black, you got the rule section, 29. So for example, additional optional rules, right? Lots of charts in here. U.S. variants. You'll recognize. Oh, variants. Yeah, Third Reich. You can play with variants. Me and my partner. So that's another optional rule. Page 106. Axis and Allies variant. Eastern Front preparation. Let's see here. This weather. Partisans. Got country rules. You might recognize this where you have labels. If you played some of the others, you're like, oh, Malta. Malta is a one-hex island. Blah, blah, blah. It tells you what it is. Different things. So, but what I like is, you know, you got good graphics. I might have to look at my rule book. I got to go see what the latest rule book is. Because this could be the reprint. Like I said, I'm not sure. It's dated 2012. And there weren't like a lot of changes. Mostly clarifications and stuff. Got a nice little booklet here. Your charts and tables. What's this on the back? Production cost table. And I like the fact that... it's on the matte paper, which a lot of people may not realize, but matte paper is actually more expensive for the printer and better quality than the shiny stuff. And personally, I like matte paper. But this is all your booklet of, different charts. Of course, you got your forms that you can photocopy in the back here for... You got variant tracking, which is optional. You got diplomatic record table, which I don't believe is optional. And who wouldn't want to play a strategic level game? Your annual income worksheet with growth rates. Recognize that from Third Reich. I don't remember if it has gearing limits or not. But anyways, your different conquests, all that good stuff. So these you'll need photocopies of, right? And I know they give permission to photocopy it. So it looks like I'm going to have to do that. Okay. So anyways, some nice graphics there, pictures. And then the scenarios. One of the things I like about the game, I'm going to show you, and I'll show you in the player aids too, but let's see if it's in the scenario book. It's got a pretty large section of the war's ancestry, which he talks how he began the project, some of the different games that Ed's played, it looks like Europe and golf, just kind of glancing. Advanced ETO, that's a favorite of mine. I like Advanced ETO quite a bit. But anyways, you know, and I believe there's designer notes. That this is all it right here. Designer notes, look at that. But you've got the campaign game, and you got everything, the most introductory of scenarios. I'm going to show you in the player aids, but you know, the first scenario is Poland, 1939. How many games pick that? gives you what the Germans get, where they set up, what the Poles get, where they set up. You can roll on the variant table, which is interesting. And then you got Norway. So, which is, this is going to teach you the land and air type rules. Norway is going to teach you invasions and how that works. Optional naval combat cards in this scenario. Western Front surprise rule apply to this scenario. Gives you rules reference, and the Allied player sets up first. Germany, let's see what they get. An evasion chit, that's used for the Germans to evade the British fleet. Then you get France 40, and you know, if I happen to do a series, I may not go in order. Get a scenario here on the Atlantic Lifeline, so I'm assuming that's the strategic warfare. A med scenario, looks like. North Africa. You get a wide variety of scenarios here. Barbarossa. D-Day to VA, so VE Day, a 44 scenario. East Front, 44, and of course the campaign is one of the things. Well, everything that's interesting about this game is you have a technology research system that, like you said, I have played it. Pretty expensive, and it, but you can advance, and technology impacts things like stacking. So in the different technology levels, but here's your order of battle cards. You know, at start, forces, then the 39 force pool, 40, 42, 44. Extra stuff. It has NARFs instead of BRPs, which are, I don't remember what it stands for, actually, off the top of my head. And then strategic moves, how many air bases you get. Pops or political points and rail moves, that might be the strategic moves. Like you said, it's been a little while since I played. You got Britain, these are all one-sided. You got one for Britain, one for the Soviet Union. You've got France and Italy, same card, opposite, so they can, you know, face opposite ends of the table. Got the United States. And then, of course, you're going to have, these are the technology. Let me show you that separate. And then you've got a German force pool. So, and it gives you the unit type and then how many you get of each, right? Let's see. Yeah, so, and maybe, is it army level? I don't think, it could be, maybe it is, because looking at this, I don't remember, I gotta read it, it's been a while, But these are the what's interesting, and it's pretty expensive. So this has got Soviet Union, U.S. entry, U.S., France, Britain, and Soviet. Got a card for the Allies and a card for the Axis with their naval construction. And then they're different, you start out, you know, third rate. Let's see if I remember this. Italy. Yeah, so you have Army, Navy, Air, right? And you got third rate, they progress through that, then second rate, and it takes a while, but you can pay to increase, you know, once you get this, and you become a second rate power, and then a first rate power. And I think fourth rate are disrupted, and then you have the construction, naval construction pools, and where their construction city. So Kiel and Wilhelmshaven for the Germans, potential third port, and Trieste and Genoa for the Italians. The Allies, the Soviets, of course, you got started third rate. So the French, British started second rate. In fact, they're the only second rate power, it looks like. And they have a little bit armies, yeah. So if I remember right, their air and naval, I don't think start at first rate, but I could be wrong. Anyways, it'll be an interesting journey if I decide to do a series of videos on this. And like I said, the cards are optional, but a little matrix here, don't know what that quite means. But that's some of the player aids. We've got more. I know there's more in here. There's a lot of player aids in this game. Nice stack of counters. Let's see here. Yep. I have a punch set that's clipped. But anyways, nice, very bold, easy to read. You know, you got infantry, armor, of course, some AA units there, some partisans, your different air counters and your fleet markers, not individual ships in this game. And we got, how many counter sheets we got here? Let me count them here. We got one, looks like 10. Looks like all together is 11 counter sheets, including your markers and whatnot. And so let's see what 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24. Anyways, I'm not going to count them. A lot of counters. Nice, fairly nice thickness. Some people complain. They're not back printed, so you could magnetize the game pretty easily if you want. And we'll look at all the counter sheets. But we got Brits, Americans, Russians, French, and different markers in there for the Soviets. And this is strategic move. Oh, SMPs are strategic movement points. Okay. And then you get different offenses. S strategic. I forgot exactly what the abbreviations are. But yeah, those are informationals. Germans. Look at the rules real quick. Now I'm like, what is the scale? You got weather markers up here. Some different miners, it looks like. Ukraine, Slovakia, Bulgaria, Yugoslavia. You mark your battle hexes. So patrols, right? That's naval. And the informationals are not back printed either. That's just, anyways, some of the counters. Decent mix there. And then one thing you do get, oh yeah, the nifty little, so, okay, let me separate this out a little bit for you before I show you. Let's see if I can find the one I'm looking for. Some scenario. Okay, well, anyways, we'll go through those in just a minute, and then I'll show you the maps. Then we'll be done. You get this nice little chart here. I'm going to show you. Just kind of gives you, so that way you know if you're missing any counters. Gives you the breakdown of all the miners and what their counters. So you can bust them out on there. Use that to do an inventory. Now, I would probably do it on paper, but, you know, I use this too, but all your countries, they're a national something resource, or NARS, right? But you can use this if you wanted to mark basically your economy levels, right? You get Soviets and all your allies, neutral and sympathizer countries, and then the Axis. So that would get a little crowded. I'd probably do it on paper. And I'm going to show you the map here. One thing that is kind of unique, I think, with the game. And I guess I'll do this as an unboxing or general thoughts, I guess, because it really is a kind of in-depth unboxing. But I'm a big fan. Each of the scenarios, I'm going to see if I can put these in. I'm not going to show it all them all to you, but let's see here. It's on the flip side. But long story short, all the scenarios have a card that is a player aid. And it kind of helps you in a neat way. Let's see here. France. It's almost like a step-by-step guide for your player aid sequence of play, but literally, like, this is for Poland, and it'll guide you step by step what you need to do each turn. Okay, so that's literally scenario one, and then this one, scenario two is in here somewhere, but this jumps to scenario three, the invasion of France, and you can already see it has more steps. So it's almost kind of like a programmed instruction. Let's see, scenario five. Just looking off to the side here, six. So we're going to want, I'm going to put one on top. But literally, every scenario has its own player aid card with the sequence of play getting down to the full campaign. And of course, the full campaign is two sides of what you need to do. So, I don't know. I like it. Some reason this game doesn't seem to get a lot of play, and I don't know why, but I'm going to rectify that. Like I said, I've played it myself, and it was when it first came out, was when I played it, and looking forward to playing it on Vassal, but maybe I am going to just bust this out and play it, because I got Toller Creek Ultimate Edition going, but you can see it's just two maps, and there you go, nice and clear what the terrain is, I think, nicely marked borders, and whatnot, and the turns for this, oh my gosh. I'm really has been a while since I played this. I want to say quarterly turns. Let's look in the rule book here. I'll read that to you if it has it right up front. Yeah, here we go. Time, unit, and map scales. Right? So, the war is a strategic level game, and each turn, so quarterly turns, each one's, so you have 4 turns a year. Ground units are corps or army sized. Fleets are actual naval task forces. Your air units are air forces or air fleets. Each is composed of several hundred aircraft and supporting units. And then the hex scale is 60 miles per hex. And you'll recognize from reading World at War, Third Reich, explains what each unit is. You know, it's fairly decent font. Not too bad. So, anyways, Compass Games, The War, 1939-45, and been having some indecisiveness of what to actually do my next series on. So, still kind of there, but now after pulling this out, knowing how much I like strategic games, whether it's World War II, World War I, Napoleonics, etc., maybe a safe bet that this might be it. Still not quite sure, because I got Raid on St. Nazaire I want to do, The Longest Day, on and on and on. And I don't necessarily have a lot of time left to do it. So, anyways, thank you for watching. And thank you for being there for me. And I think we're going to just look. We're going to see. This just might be it. This might be the game that we do. So thanks for joining me. It's Mark Ruggiero, Clark Commando, 1983, signing off. And until I decide what to do, I'll just keep doing videos. Thanks for joining me. Bye.